sees the team. The game is on. Bergeron and Crosby. Bergeron pulls up in the corner. Jack Johnson blocks the shot. Dominic Simone pulls up short of the red line. Crosby drive, scores! 24 seconds into the game, Pittsburgh is ahead.
Finds open space up the left wing when Boston can't get the puck to the net. Here comes that counterattack. Nice little pull up here by Simone. And he finds Crosby on the opposite side of the ice. And he just tees one up from inside the tops of the circle. Everybody raves about his ability to make plays, but this guy's a goal scorer too, and that's a great finish. Beats Halak, left side, just inside the far post.
The power play for Boston. Anders Bjork over the line, Charlie Coyle's shot, and Jari gobbles it up.
It makes a beautiful pass right through the middle. You can see Pastrnak coming late. Pittsburgh wary of that. That allows an easy walk-in.
All the way back to McAvoy, to Krizlik, to Heinen, draws Letang. Bjork turns and shoots, and Jari makes a stick save. Crosby snaps the puck back to center. Bergeron, the quick re-entry. DeBrus to Bergeron! Can't tuck it past Jari, who left the right leg behind to block the post shot. Heinen to Krizlik, closes, fakes the shot. McAvoy's shot with purpose to Heinen. And Jari makes another save. 10 seconds left. Malkin barrels through until Carlo pokes the puck away. Malkin pursuing Krug, gets the puck loose. Dominic Cahoon yields to Patterson, the rocket, and a blocker save by Halak. John Moore to Charlie McAvoy. Long to the attacking line. Carson Kuhlman gets his first touch in 88 days. And it's an assist to Sean Correll.
That give and go. Get the puck wide, drive to the net. Purposeful shot. I don't know if that hits the leg of Jack Johnson or the stick of Kuhlman. But regardless who gets credit for this goal, hard to tell if that's the shaft of the stick or the leg pad of Johnson, the defenseman for the Penguins. But impact for Carson Kuhlman, first shift of the game.
On Pastrnak and Marchand with Carlo and Krug. Back at the blue line, Tory Krug goes right to goal. Stuffs it in front, Bergeron whacks it clear. And Pastrnak's shot gets blocked.
By Ruweedle. But the Bruins keep the puck alive, and David Pastrnak able to jump on it for a second chance opportunity.
Do you think this little setback is going to make you immune from us making fun of you? You're dead wrong. Lindholm tips in Kuhlman's long pass. Carson Kuhlman, 88 days on the shelf. 12:16 into the game, has a multi-point game.
You know, shot on goal is never a bad play. But if you have a better play to be made, and it's a nice force and a nice pass by Heinen, again, being hard on the puck for Danton Heinen. We're seeing more and more of that out of these young guys because it's required. Kuhlman tries to make a play on the puck. He's the third man high. Read and react. All of a sudden, Heinen's able to make a play. Pick it up. Look at those eyes. He's looking right at the net.
Looking middle for Carlo now. Carlo's got to hustle because he's on the wrong side of the puck. And Charlie Coyle knocks down the Malkin pass. That would have led to a numerical advantage. Meanwhile, Marchand shoots and Jari makes a save. Backpedaling as he lost balance, his skates against the kick plate. Johnson can't control. Coyle couldn't lift the puck through Jari.
What a stop.
And it rolls back to the Boston zone. Krug backhands to Marchand. He's got Pastrnak middle. And a save by Jari. Here's an assist.
Yeah, it's a nice little quick up by Tory Krug. And it's a good look by Marchand. And a good effort by Pastrnak. I didn't think he was all that sharp in the first period, to be honest with you, Jack. Well, this is a better effort here, fighting Jack Johnson.
This season. In search of Mario. Galchenyuk. A great save by Halak. Carlo. Roller through the slot. Marchand to Bergeron. The backhand surprises Jari. He felt something go off his stick. It was the puck.
We go back to the Jari save on the little backhand hit. Traffic right through the legs of Pastrnak. You called it, Jack. The stick just in the right spot.
Pass to Reese. Over to Brandon Tanev. Gives way to Ruedel in front. Great save by Halak. Denying Kluger down the slot.
Guys, last minute, I got to back off. So now his gap is okay. You're going to give up the blue line because the forwards were thinking offense. You get caught a little deep. You're just a stride and a half behind the play. It allows Ruedel to jump in and create numbers.
Pastrnak gains the line, whips the puck cross ice. McAvoy to Pastrnak, high in the zone. Grizzlick rotating down, goes to goal. And the rebound, Corrali wide of the net.
And here's that nice rotation in the offensive zone right off the mask. The mask is still on. It's still secure by the looks of it. Stuns him. Corrali had the chance on the rebound, and that would have counted.
Back pass, McAvoy. Uh-oh, here's a breakaway. 2-on-0, Rust and Aston Reese. Rust, a save by Halak. Mark that one down. And another off Aston Reese. Golden opportunities.
Well, we love the fact that Krug settled his disagreement with Hornquist, but now you don't have him for the power play. And the Bruins aren't making great decisions out by the blue line. Pastrnak tried to go back to Grizzlick. That led to numbers the first time where Halak had to make a save. Charlie McAvoy, you're trying to get him to shoot the puck.
Bergeron 9-for-15 coming into the third period. And the Bruins control. Bergeron now 2-for-2. Against Evgeny Malkin. Pastrnak to Bergeron, he scores! That was a dart!
Face-off win, good help from Grizzlick, who lined up on the outside hash. That allows Kahlo, being the right-handed shot, to pick that puck up and move towards the boards. He doesn't have a direct outlet, so he goes with a high lob. And Marsha, not sure if they'll give him a helper on this play or not, Jack. But he forces that puck back in the direction of Pastrnak. And Pastrnak knows he has Bergeron. He surveyed what was available to him before he gets the puck.
Puck comes off his stick handle. Letang. Carlos Rocket, a save by Jari. With the stick lift on Chara. Crosby cannot beat Halak. McAvoy goes down, the puck loose. McCann tries to throw it over the pile. Still loose. And the whistle. Two places at once. Rust to Crosby, a save by Halak. Hornquist with the net drive. Turns it back to Chris Letang alone at the blue line. Now Malkin switches with him. Rust closes to a stick. Letang's drive. Bergeron clears it the length of the rink. Into the final minute. Letang, Pastrnak, Marchand. Wow! What a tremendous teammate Pastrnak is, beating the snake-bitten Marchand for the capper.
How can that be? He's too good of a player. He's too good of a goal scorer. And the first opportunity he had on the empty net, he hit the side of the net, and you're thinking, wow, that could have got him off the schneid a little bit in terms of scoring goals. And then the force by Bergeron, the turnover by the Penguins off in their own zone that ended up going in the back of the net at the opposite end tells you something. The goaltending of Halak.
Pettersson with 2 seconds to go. And the Bruins beat the Penguins 4-1.